Welcome back to our channel, and today we thought we'd do a video on how to start your eating disorder recovery. So this is something that is obviously going to be not obviously, but it will most likely be different for every single person who's suffering with the eating disorder. We thought we'd just give you an overview of sort of how Sam got into recovery, because I think it's a hard thing. Like, how do you know when you're in recovery? So basically, what we keep referring back to Mum's books, but it's because it's like based on our journey. But in Mum's book, she always says that the sufferer has to want to get better for, you know, any sort of recovery to happen. And I think that's when you know, or when the carer knows, when the sufferer knows that in recovery is when they actively want to get better, whether that be taking really small baby steps or whether that be like, right, I'm ready, let's do it.
You'll kind of notice it in them, because it won't be like, oh man, I've got to do this. They still will be dreading it, and they still will be finding it hard, but you'll just notice that they want to push through it a bit more.
Yeah.
They won't suddenly be like, yeah, I'm just going to eat this, or and then it'll
they
be fine.
They might do, though.
Yeah, they might do. That'd be great.
Yeah, that would be good things, but...
good things. So, yeah, you will notice it in their mindset. You will notice that maybe they don't want to do it, but they do, sort of thing. Does that make sense?
Yeah. I think there is any want to get better, whether that be like a really small one, but it needs to be like a, sometimes people who are suffering might say that they do, but they might not mean it. So I think it's the physically seeing them wanting to and actually doing something about it, not just saying it and not doing anything to
do it. Follow up them words.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah, but Sam, so the moment, Sam's was more of like a light bulb on moment.
Yeah.
Eureka.
Yeah, mine was like a, and then I was like, no, it wasn't really. But
like, you were a bit though.
I was, like, I can't bottle that moment up and give it to people. I wish I could. But yeah, I had this moment where I was just like, I've had enough. The next day, I didn't like go crazy, but I just made an effort to eat more, and I mean, it's not that simple, obviously, but for me, I just knew I needed to eat because I was very low weight.
Basically, we were on holiday in Spain, and at this time, we had this we had a house over there, and we used to go over there like every holiday, every like school holiday and stuff. And Mum just got to the point where she was like every time we would go, there'd be like, obviously Sam would be ill. And,
yeah, we'd just ruin the
like,
holiday.
It was just, yeah, it was just like. And then it got to a point where Mum was like, when is this going to stop?
Yeah.
And I remember she sent me off to like walk to the shops or something. Dad wasn't there, I think. He was coming at a later date. So I was just like, I'll walk to the shops. And then Mum was having a chat with Sam, but she was saying like to Sam, like, basically you're going to ruin yourself.
And ruin the family.
And ruin the family. And like, you just, like, when is this going to stop?
And yeah.
I don't know, I wasn't in the
and
chat.
I
can just make it up, right? No. But it was along those lines.
Probably all the things you actually wanted to say to me.
Yeah.
I just remember, and I knew all these things were happening, not as much as they were, like, I didn't know how much pain was going around, but I knew that pain was going around, and I hated it, like, I hated putting everyone through that. And she was like, I'll give you anything, if I could give you anything, if you got better. I think a lot of people do this. What would it be? Oh, the things I could have asked for. what I'd ask
house,
for now.
House, car.
I know.
What did you ask for?
I wanted to run down the beach in a bikini. But when you're that...
That's nice.
But when you're like that ill and you're that wrapped up in it...
It's not that, the physical, it's not...
Yeah, you don't want these other things, you just want everything to go away, and you just want to be okay. And sometimes I even forget now, although I still struggle a bit, that I'm so lucky to be okay, and we're all lucky to be okay.
But you don't struggle with the eating disorder?
No, not the eating disorder, but yeah, like OCD.
Yeah.
But we're cool with that.
Yeah. But That's, yeah, it's just an interesting one, isn't it? Because I don't think we've spoken about that moment before. And literally, it was like a switch,
yeah, wasn't it? Really
the next
weird.
Day, you were like determined. And yeah. I remember like you eating like these massive flapjacks. And then I used to come and...
Mate, the things I ate. I ate these flapjacks. They were humongous, weren't they?
They weren't that big.
Nah, that's probably that big in my head. They were like that big.
As in that long.
And quite like wide. Thick. I ate two. At night, every night, and then, but on top of everything else. But I was literally like, I went to sleep with tummy aches. Maybe I did it a bit too quick. However, I got there, so I just wanted to get there so much. But if someone doesn't have that moment, or you don't have that moment, I believe kind of making small steps is the best way, and compromising. So, for example, I see so many things where it's very like, you have to do it, and they struggle and they struggle and they struggle, and it ends up in a relapse. Does that make sense? They'll struggle so they can't challenge themselves the next day.
From like a carer's point of view, it can be really frustrating, obviously, to watch like your loved one doing these things or going through the eating disorder. Obviously we're talking about anorexia here, but I think it can be like broadened that basically it's the want to get better. And like Sam says, for us, we weren't like lucky, but obviously it was like more of a quick decision. But for others, just any inkling of small positive changes, there's something to be like so applauding of and proud of, because it just shows that little bit of want and motivation to change. And
even if it's a small thing to you, it's a massive thing to them. And if you kind of encourage them and keep telling them they're doing well and giving them the praise, because the thing is with anorexia is often when the sufferer doesn't eat, the anorexia will then praise them. They'll then be like, yeah, well done. That's just what the illness does. It's really messed up, but that's what I had anyway. And that's where they're getting their kind of like, yeah, I'm doing well, even though you're not. But anyway, if you kind of take over that, if you give a positive, like, yeah, you're doing well, and you make them feel good, and you make them feel like they're back in control, and they're kind of moving forward, and they're getting their life back, that will be a massive help. I remember seeing a documentary, and a young girl had, she'd been to a clinic, and I think she'd come out, and she did amazing. She, you know, she put on some weight. She was well on the way to recovery. And I think she wanted to like celebrate it. She wanted to do something. She wanted to be like, can we celebrate it? Because I've had a year in here and I'm out now. And I don't, and this is no fault to the family, because they, again, it's such a hard illness to understand, but I don't think they did anything. And then she had a relapse because she wasn't getting that.
She wasn't getting enough you almost need to be like,
the angel from the devil.
Yeah, that's what Sam used to say, is like the anorexia was the devil on one shoulder and then mum was the angel on the other. And you've almost got to overpower, but overpower with positivity and kindness and understanding and non-judgment, even though you might feel like shaking that you have to.
That's what you wanted to do to me.
I wanted to be like, But you almost have to, because the anorexia, like Sam said, they're like, well done, like, if you...
Well, that's like your best friend, isn't it? They call it Anna. And it's a person that's your best friend that's telling you you're doing well. And I find people that fall into anorexia often in a place where they don't know where they are, you know, they don't feel like they're in control, and then this thing comes along and it's like, well done.
But everyone, whether you've got a mental illness or not, everyone loves a bit of praise and positivity, and it's no different.
Yeah, I mean, like, it doesn't have to be like a full-on party. You can just buy them like a small gift or a card or...
Or even just words, like, by saying, words. Like, well done, we're so proud of you, like, blah, blah, blah. I was just thinking,
yeah.
Anyway, sorry.
Yeah, so I think that's it, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. Thanks for listening, guys. We hope we made sense.
Probably not, but yeah, so we hope we've made sense, and we will see you in the next video.
Thanks, guys. Bye.